This video was brought to you by us, Slidebean. Make beautiful slide presentations in no time. Get one free month by signing up at slidebean.com/YouTube. 2012 saw the release of an outbreaking future tech product, Google Glass, a gadget in the style of an invention you might have seen previously on any Mission Impossible movie. Its primary aim was to bring you the information you need into view when you need it with a hands-free system. In fact, analyzing the features of this invention might make you feel like you're living in a Black Mirror episode. Well, Google Glass was never as popular as the dystopian futuristic Netflix series. Dystopian, however, might be a good way of describing Google Glass's performance as a commercial product and its outcome. They are now heading towards the end, or at least very far from its original purpose. When did the criticism toward this product start? To be honest, as soon as it was announced that it was going to be made available to a few small number of users at launch, and that the cost was going to be $1,500. After facing many issues for several years, Google announced the end of the first iteration of the augmented reality smart glasses, the Glass Explorer Edition. However, that doesn't mean it's the final goodbye. They are now leaning towards a new approach with the Enterprise Edition, a business-driven model that was officially launched in 2017. In this Startup Forensics, we are going to go over the starting point of this product, the company's original expectations when it released, the apparently attractive characteristics and features that it offered, and the problems that accompanied during its short life. And we'll share some details of what might seem to be in the future for this phase-worn computer device. We'll also talk about competitors that might have learned which way not to go, considering the failures of this shattered Google's product. So this is Startup Forensics, Google Glass. How and why was it released? The primary aim of Google Glass was to display the information the users needed, presenting it right into their eyes' view. When it was launched during Google I/O in Mountain View in 2012, it seemed it was going to bring this glimpse into the future of technology. The first model was called Glass Explorer Edition, launched in 2013. The company really wanted this product to succeed, and they announced it with great fanfare. The spy-like wearable invention was described by some as a heads-up display. But the reality is that as soon as it came out, criticism started both from the users and from specialized journalists. At the very beginning, if you wanted to get the glasses, you not only needed more than $1,500, but at the same time, you had to be in a very VIP list that included Google I/O developers and some privileged Twitter users. By the way, how could somebody be privileged via Twitter? Did that $1,500 price make sense, considering its early and experimental device? Well, maybe not. These series of obstacles made the invention not only unattractive, but also a little bit of a meme. The design also generated some negative reviews. The bulky frames, not that similar to a conventional pair of glasses, was a point of conversation. Even the offensive moniker "glasshole" brought some attention to the glasses, but not for a convincing attribute. Were there more questionings about the gadget? Of course. But to understand them, first we need to go over the details on why Google thought their smart glasses might be a good commercial idea. Long story short, they are a set of glasses that includes a screen to users' eyesight that brings new possibilities for them to interact with the world. The glass was developed by Google X Division, and it came with an optical head mounted display with almost the same shape of a pair of normal glasses, including a visible display. For the time of its release, it was kind of ahead of its time, with technologically advanced features that bring live directions, emails, weather forecast, and a personalized contact list, and everything within the tap of the frame or even with voice commands, triggered with a friendly OK Glass to be activated. The pros and cons. After going over the menu system, some attractive features would come up, including a city guide and a universal translator called the World Lens, useful for translating any language from menus, road signs, or printed text. It was just like carrying an interpreter with you. Refresh was also attractive. It turned the glasses into a personal assistant capable of sharing information about the people you were about to meet by collecting select data from social networks and from your Google Calendar. A lot of things, right? But now we need to make a stop into one of the most important features that it had, a built-in camera that allowed you to use the frames to take pictures and shoot video. This was not only one of its main attributes, but one of its most controversial characteristics. The 5-megapixel camera came with a lot of criticism, especially because it is kind of invasive to be able to save memories all day long from a first witness point of view without the permission of anyone in front of it. This issue was not a minor thing. During the first few months after the product's release, some public places announced that they were going to ban the device completely in their properties because it might be violating existing privacy laws. "Are you recording me?" was a common question thrown around for smart glass users, mostly by intrigued or furious people in the streets. Obviously, not everybody would be in favor of being filmed or pictured in public places. At the point of release, Google Glass already presented three big concerns: bulky price, privacy issues, and design. When problems came in, it was obvious that this product was not gonna be the planned hit. So what did Google do? First, the fate of Google Glass went on for an extended period of time, leaving people in the dark for a period of time. It was in 2015 that they pulled the glasses off shelves and replaced the wearable with an enterprise-focused device. That year, they stopped making it available to consumers, but something else came on the way. The company discovered the gadget was becoming popular in work environments. But before going over the second generation, we should clarify something. Why are we talking about this product? Because it's now getting its last and final update, marking the end of an era. I mean, this might sound like an exaggeration. At least it's marking the end of a not too privileged lifetime period. The latest announcement from Google said that they were rolling out a new and final software update for their Google Glass Explorer Edition wearable. This update means that after February 25th, 2020, it will no longer be possible to link Glass with a Google account. Then the device will be connected to a smartphone via Bluetooth, but without any Google backend services. At the same time, apps like YouTube, Hangouts, and Gmail will stop working. What does this mean? Well, mainly that after this last update, Google is gently sending its Explorer Edition model not to the freezer, but to the grave, when some of its most attractive features will just cease to function. So let's go back a few years ago while Google tested waters. At the same time, some competitors came on board in the smart glasses industry. With smart glasses, we mean those devices able to beam graphics and notifications with internal smart modules. Bosch SensorTech, for example, launched a wearable technology called Smart Glasses Light Drive with a more attractive look and feel, with far fewer possibilities to bring in a moniker to their users. It has no visible display, no integrated camera, avoiding this way the criticism Google Glass had since day one. There are also rumors about Apple working on a branded augmented reality option to release to the market. While the new version of Google Glass is Android-based, this one will be sold as an iPhone accessory, and we might see it in the market as soon as 2020. One may think that this means Google Glass derailed completely from the company's first expectations. But even if this attempt failed, it meant the birth of another device that seems to be performing better. The enterprise version of the sci-fi glasses became a successful invention for another audience. The business-targeted smart glasses headset has been already released in two models. Their cost is $999. Recently, the project lead of Google Glass, Jay Kothari, announced the latest version of the enterprise glasses. He assured that as their customers had adopted Glass, they received valuable feedback that helped them improve and come up with Glass Enterprise Edition 2. It's evident that with the new features of this release, the company acknowledged most of the mistakes made in the design and the development of the Google Glass that was released in 2012. Among many important changes, they have reduced the cost to consumers by almost 33% compared to the first model. The main objective of this enterprise line is to improve productivity in the workplace. And with this new goal on the horizon, they're kind of making it. The product has great acceptance in businesses eager to adopt it. It's still kind of early to describe this model as a hit among industries, especially because the company is reluctant to share the number of models sold. But at least it's shown that it's been of great help for employees to work better, smarter, and faster in areas like logistics, manufacturing, and medicine, among others. It allows professionals to access information hands-free while working. Some of the clients using it are airplane enterprise Boeing and a startup in the medical world called Omedics. Now, the glasses are being used to save time to doctors that are able to see more patients while attending phone calls or analyzing lab results. Giving a second life to glass-related smart innovations was for sure a smart move by Google. Now, the lenses are not only in everyday life, but in the job where they're not going to have that many privacy concerns. Is Google gaining ground again with the change in its business vision? No pun intended. When the company aimed to present a new face with the enterprise device, they started breathing again. It seems that they've wisely found a way to reposition themselves in the augmented reality business. The turning from Explorer to Enterprise Edition seems to be taking full effect, and it seems the grass is greener on this side. So for this Startup Forensics case, We'll call the body not completely dead. Maybe we're talking about a zombie or some resurrected being.